This is Pratima from Planet Physiology, and today we are going to learn about muscle spindle. This topic will be dealt under the following headings: structure of the muscle spindle, mechanism of stimulation of muscle spindle, and its function. Skeletal muscle fibers consist of extrafusal fibers and intrafusal fibers. Extrafusal fibers are the actual contractile muscle fibers that produce muscle contraction, and they are innervated by alpha motor neurons in the spinal cord. Whereas, intrafusal fibers are covered by a fusiform capsule. They are spindle in shape and they act as stretch receptors. So basically, they detect changes in the length of individual muscle as well as rate of change in the muscle length. So muscle spindle is encapsulated, multinucleated, spindle-shaped or fusiform structure. They are placed parallel to the extrafusal fibers and their capsule is connected with the tendons on the either side. Nuclei are concentrated in the central non-contractile region of the muscle spindle, whereas peripheral portion is contractile in nature. Now let us study the details of this muscle spindle. It is made up of two types of intrafusal fibers, and they are nuclear bag fibers and nuclear chain fibers. In case of nuclear bag fibers, central portion is dilated to form a bag-like structure which contains nuclei. There are about 2 to 3 nuclear bag fibers in each spindle. Nuclear bag fibers are of two types, dynamic and static. Dynamic nuclear bag fibers are also known as nuclear bag fibers 1, whereas static fibers are also known as nuclear bag fibers 2. Dynamic nuclear bag fibers are concerned with detection of rapid changes in the muscle length during the movement, whereas static nuclear bag fibers along with the nuclear chain fibers are concerned with detection of steady state length in the muscle fiber. Usually there are 3 to 9 nuclear chain fibers in the muscle spindle, and in this case nuclei are arranged as a single chain in the central portion of these fibers. Now coming to the afferents of muscle spindle. Afferent fibers innervate central portion of nuclear bag as well as nuclear chain fibers, and they are of two types. First is primary afferents. They are also known as annulospiral endings, and these are type 1A fibers with conduction velocity of 70 to 120 meters per second. They innervate both nuclear bag as well as nuclear chain fibers, and they are rapidly adapting fibers. Primary afferents are sensitive to rate of change of muscle length during the stretch. That is, they detect rapid changes in the speed of the movement, and thus they also allow quick corrective movements. This is called as dynamic response. These afferents synapse directly with alpha motor neurons in the spinal cord that innervate extrafusal fibers of the same muscle. So shown in this picture, these are the annulospiral endings transmitting their signals in the primary afferent, and primary afferent synapse with the alpha motor neuron. Secondary afferents or flower spray endings are type 2 nerve fibers with conduction velocity ranging between 30 to 70 meters per second. They innervate static nuclear bag fibers as well as nuclear chain fibers. Secondary endings are slow adapting receptors, and these fibers along with annulospiral endings are responsible for static response. That means they respond to steady state length of the muscle, and hence they maintain the particular position of the muscle for a given duration. These fibers mainly make polysynaptic connections with anterior horn cells in the spinal cord, but few also synapse directly with the motor neurons and contribute to stretch reflex. Now let us study about the efferent of the muscle spindle. Gamma motor neurons of anterior horn cells of the spinal cord form efferent fibers to the muscle spindle. They constitute about 30% of the fibers in the ventral root and innervate contractile regions of the muscle spindle, that is the polar ends or the peripheral parts of the muscle spindle. Efferents are also of two types. First is gamma dynamic efferent, which is also known as gamma 1 efferent. They form plate endings and innervate only dynamic nuclear back fibers. Stimulation of these fibers increases sensitivity of dynamic annulospiral endings during the changes in the muscle length. Gamma static efferents are also known as gamma 2 efferents and they form trail endings. They innervate static nuclear back fibers as well as nuclear chain fibers. Stimulation of these fibers increases the activity of both primary as well as secondary afferents. It also decreases dynamic sensitivity of primary afferents and thus they play important role in sustained contraction of the muscle. Now let us study how muscle spindle is stimulated and how it works. As the spindles are placed parallel to the extrafusal fibers and their capsules are attached to the muscle tendons, passive stretching of muscle also causes stretching of the muscle spindle. This causes stretching of the central portion of the muscle spindle and stimulation of annulospiral endings. This in turn stimulate alpha motor neurons leading to contraction of the same muscle. So thus, this forms basis for deep tendon reflexes. Muscle spindle also can be stimulated via gamma motor neurons. Gamma motor neurons are usually under the influence of various descending tracts. They are also stimulated during anxiety or during performing the Gentasix maneuver. So, stimulation of gamma motor neurons causes contraction of only the peripheral portions of the muscle spindle. This in turn causes stretching of the central part of the spindle where there are sensory endings. Stimulation of these sensory receptors causes stimulation of alpha motor neurons leading to muscle contraction. Sometimes you will come across the words loading and unloading of the spindle. So, let us understand this concept. As I mentioned just now, passive stretching of the muscle also causes stretching of the muscle spindle and this increases the transmission of impulses in the afferent nerve in the same proportion as that of degree of stretch and this is called as loading of the spindle. Whereas stimulation of alpha motor neurons causes shortening of the muscle and this inhibits impulse generation in the muscle spindle afferents. This is called as unloading of the spindle. Now let us study the functions of muscle spindle. The first function is it acts as sensory receptors in case of stretch reflex. Second, it plays important role in alpha gamma coactivation. This part we will see in the next slide in detail. The third important function of muscle spindle is damping function or signal averaging function. Here, muscle spindle helps in smooth progression of the movement by preventing oscillations. Primary afferents play important role in preventing oscillations. Next function is detection of muscle length. Muscle spindles constantly transmit signals regarding the length of the muscle even at rest. They also detect changes in the muscle length throughout the contraction as well as relaxation and this helps in adjusting the muscle length during voluntary activities. The last function of the muscle spindle is detection of velocity of muscle contraction. So, muscle spindle detects the speed at which muscle is being stretched or contracting. And again, primary afferents play important role in this function. Now, let us study this alpha-gamma coactivation. During voluntary movements, descending tracts send simultaneous signals to alpha as well as gamma motor neurons. This simultaneous activation of alpha and gamma motor neurons is referred as alpha-gamma coactivation. Due to this coactivation, there is simultaneous contraction of both extrafusal as well as intrafusal fibers and this leads to smooth progression of the motor activity up to the desired extent. Thus, it helps in maintaining the sensitivity of the spindle during contraction and also during the reflex adjustment of alpha motor discharge. This is essential to continue the contraction till the desired limit is reached. If alpha gamma coactivation is absent, contraction cannot last for sufficient time to perform the desired movement. So here we finish with the muscle spindle. Let us summarize the important points quickly. Muscle spindle is stretch receptors present in the skeletal muscle. They have two types of fibers, nuclear back fibers and nuclear chain fibers. They are innervated by two types of afferents, primary or annular spiral endings, which are type 1A afferent, and secondary or flower spray ending, which are type 2 afferents. Again, there are two types of efferents, gamma dynamic efferents, which are also called as plate endings, and gamma static efferents, which are also called as trail endings. Muscle spindle can be stimulated either by passive stretch of the muscle or because of stimulation of gamma motor neurons. And stimulation of muscle spindle elicits stretch reflex. So this is a diagram which indicates stretch reflex. Stretching of the muscle stimulates primary afferent. They in turn synapse with the alpha motor neuron, and alpha motor neuron in turn causes contraction of the extrafusal fibers of the same muscle, leading to their contraction. So this is all about muscle spindle. Thank you. If you enjoy my sessions, press the like button and share it with your friends. If you haven't yet subscribed my channel, press the subscribe button. To get notifications about new releases, press bell icon. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.